have to remove this one, the whole clutch of the starting motor is gonna fall down, and I'll be able to remove the crankshaft off the chain that connects the crankshaft and the alternator axle. That's the whole assembly. And now the crankshaft can come out. Okay, we separated the engine, we've done everything. Crankcases are upper, lower, the crankshaft is out. Now, how do we see what exactly do we need? Well, I've done all this job in order to replace the main bearings of the crankshaft and of course the conrod bearings, which are in here, in the conrods, in here, lower, upper, lower, upper, lower, upper, and lower, upper on this one. We have four conrods, so we're gonna need a set of four bearings for the conrods, and we have a set of five joints for the crankshaft bearings. How can you tell if they are damaged? How can you tell if you're going to replace them or not? Well, one thing is so many thousand kilometers, I mean 75, I can't remember how many thousand Ks. Well, I thought there'll be a need of replacement, especially when I realized that the quality of the oil inside the engine was absolutely rubbish. And they misused that bike a lot in the past. But still, how can you tell? Can you see that color up there? This is the bearing, right? Can you see that color up there? Right there, that kind of color, that's light gray. Or you can see it here, much better condition. Light gray, this is good. This, what it's supposed to be the color for the whole bearing. But now, can you see, it becomes dark gray. That means the first layer has been worn. And it's a good idea to replace it, because you don't dismantle the engine that often, would you? If never in a motorcycle's lifetime, once. So for me, it's a good idea to replace it now. In some cases, you might even be able to see that it changes color to reddish. And I can see on this one, the light is not ideal, so on these sides, both here and here, if you pay close attention, you'll see it becomes slightly reddish. The problem is when it becomes really red, that means it's totally worn, and you're probably gonna have to replace the crankshaft as well, or take it for machining or whatever. Now, crankshaft, you inspect, I did before. I have my gloves now. You take your gloves off and you put your fingernail in here and you try to see if there's any scratches. Visually first, of course, and then with your finger. But as much as I could see, there was no scratches, there was nothing. Let me take a light. It's absolutely clean. You might see those lines there, but they're not any scratches or anything. It's absolutely in great condition. And thank God for that, otherwise I would have been in trouble, paying big bucks for a used even crankshaft. I'm not even sure if Yamaha provides brand new crankshafts for this FZR series. Okay, I realized that I need new bearings for conrods and from the main for the crankshaft. How do I know which ones I need? Because unlike cars, motorcycles have a different system. They're not all the same thickness here. The thickness of the joints of this crankshaft or of the conrods it's not the same. Cars, they have a standard and they'll tell you, okay, if you go to machine it because it's damaged, 0.10, 0.20 or half millimeter oversize and you're good. Motorcycles is not like that. Well, every motorcycle that I've seen, it's not like that at all. They're all different. Yeah, sometimes might be one or two or three even joints same size, but this one's different from this one and this one's different from this one. How can you tell? For Yamaha, I'm not sure about other manufacturers, but for Yamaha, they mark them with color. So if you see on the bearing here, just above my fingernail, you'll see there's a slightly green color. Over there, I can't see much, but I think I saw just before brown color. One or the other side of the bearing should have all of them colored. This is brown. This one seems to be green as well, but see, after so many years the color had faded. How can you tell what color is it? Imagine if you ordered the wrong color. You're gonna destroy your engine, and all this job was done for nothing. How can you tell? For the FZR series, and I'm pretty sure that might work for every other Yamaha motorcycle that uses that kind of bearings for the crankshaft and the cornrods, they have five colors: blue, black, brown, green and yellow. How can you tell which one do you need, since, well, you can't see the color, had faded because of so many years and so many thousand Ks and so many heat up, cool down rotations during the motorcycle's lifespan. First thing you need to look is the crankshaft. And you see those numbers. They are very crucial and they play a very crucial role to purchase your bearings. The first five, and in this case we have 1, 1, 1, 1, and 1. That doesn't mean much. It can be totally different or all of them the same. The first five, they correspond to the main bearings. These ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Remember, riding position bike. We are having from left to right, number one joint, like the cylinders. Number one cylinder, number two cylinder, number three cylinder, number four. As we have joint 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. These ones correspond to these joints. From left to right. Joint 1, joint 2, joint 3, joint 4, joint 5. There's a gap to separate them from the other four numbers, and of course these four numbers are, you guessed it, for the conrods. Let's take first the main joints. The next thing for the main joints to find out which one they are, you go to the crankcase. See these numbers here. They're upside down because when they mark them at the factory, the machine is upside down, I guess. They correspond for these numbers, for these joints as well. From left to right, providing the crankcase is on a proper position, not upside down. This is for number 1, number 2, number 3, 4 and 5. So, what do we do? You do obstruction. You obstruct these five numbers from these five numbers. So we have five for joint number one, this joint, right? First, we have number five. Over here, we have number one. 1 minus 5, 4. Well, that's the number that corresponds to a color. And number four is green. Let's see if we have green here, if we can see green. And yes, maybe you can't see it on camera, but I can tell you right now, it is green. But I can't see that one. I'm assuming it's green, but I'm not really sure. I can see something greenish there, but not really sure. So let's go and see that one. What do we have here? We have number 5 again. And here we have the second number. Good. 1 minus 5, 4. Number 4 is green. Like you see on the chart that I just uploaded, number 1, if the result of the abstraction is number 1, then it's a blue color. Number 2 is for black, number 3 is for brown, number 4 is for green, and number 5 is for yellow. There's not gonna be number 6. I'm talking always about the abstraction between these two numbers. This is how you want it. So after a simple math for my main journal, my main joints here for the crankshaft, I realized that is 1 minus 5, 4, 1 minus 5, 4, 1 minus 4, 3, 1 minus 6, 5, and 1 minus 6, 5 again. So what I want is 4, 4, 3, 5, 5. I need green bearings for this one, green bearings for this one, brown for this one, yellow and yellow. That's what I need for my main joints for the crankshaft. Now let's remove a cornrod to see. This is what we got here. It's okay, but still, there's a lot of worn. And as I said, well, if we have to replace them, let's do it now. What's the color? Brown. That is brown. But let's check the theory I was talking about before and find out if that's true. And brown, of course, here. They're always going to be identical. The top one with the bottom one have to be identical. You can't have brown here and green there. There's something wrong. There's definitely something wrong. But different cylinders, different cornrods, or different joints, they can always be different. Maybe they can be all the same. You never know. It depends how the factory made them. But that's the rules. The same procedure with the colors and the traction and everything goes for the cornrows. This is number 4, it's attached right there. But the numbers, of course, for the cornrows are here, the 4 numbers, 1, 2, 3 and 4 cylinders, so we have 2, 2, 2 and 1. The numbers that you need to strap from is right here. If you can see, that's there's numbers with a number with an ink, and I can see it right here. Let me show you. That here is number 5. So since I got the number 1, the result is number 4. And number 4, I know it's a green. Let's see on the side if I do have a green color. And yes, I can tell here this part, this little paint here on the bearing, it's green. I've done exactly the same test with the other bearings for the cornrods, and they're all the rest of them, 1, 2, and 3, they're all brown. This is how you find which bearings you want for your FZR, and that rule applies to all FZR series, 250, 400, 600, 750 and 1000, all models, all years. It's exactly the same procedure to purchase them. Not sure if that rule stands for other Yamaha motorcycles, but it definitely stands for the FZR series, regardless of the engine capacity.